So good afternoon everybody, today I am going to discuss about the length of the open belt drive. So before going into the topic, that is, this is the smaller pulley and this is the larger pulley. Within these two pulley, one will be the driver and the other will be the driven. Maybe the smaller pulley the driver, maybe the larger pulley will be the driver. So if we consider that is the small r is the radius, smaller pulley, and capital R is the radius of the larger pulley, so if the small r is the radius of the smaller is the radius of the smaller pulley and capital R is the radius of the larger pulley, then if LO is the length of the open belt, if LO is the length of the open belt drive, then we have to calculate LO. So the belt will be, which will be covered entire the pulley. So belt will be covered entire the system of this pulley, system of this belt drive or system of this pulley. So LO, that is the length of the open belt drive, if we denoted this length of the open belt drive by LO, then it will be arc of kg plus gh plus, for the larger pulley, arc of hn. So arc of hn. So from the arc of kg plus gh plus arc of hn, so it will be covered only the upper part of this belt drive. Now it will be multiplied by 2 to cover the entire belt drive, so that's why it will be multiplied by 2. So now, and what is ag here? Here BH are the common tangent. And here beta, so here angle GAC and also HBD angle beta, that is GAC angle is beta. GAC angle is beta and HBD is also angle is beta. Beta is the subtended angle between two common tangent. So now LO equals to arc of kg. So what is the formula of arc? Arc equals to r into theta. So here arc of kg, it means the radius of the smaller pulley is r into theta is here. KAC total angle is pi by 2, that is 90 degree, pi by 2 minus beta. So R into pi by 2 minus beta plus GH, that will be remain same, plus arc of HN. Arc of HN here, it will be the angle. So that angle is HBD. This angle is here beta. So here the angle will be arc of HN. It will be capital R, that is the radius of the larger pulley, that will be multiplied by the angle, that is angle DBN. This angle is here pi 90 degree angle, so pi by 2 DBN angle is pi by 2, that is 90 degree, and this angle is beta, that is HBD. So total angle will be R into pi by 2 plus beta, that will be multiplied by 2. So from here LO equals to R into pi by 2 minus beta plus capital R into pi by 2 plus beta plus GH is parallel to the AO here. GH is parallel to the AO. So we can also write, that is GH is equal to the AO. So we can also here, we can replace AO here in this equation by GH. So we can replace here GH with AO, and that will be multiplied by 2. So ultimately we will get LO equals to 2 into small r into pi by 2 minus beta plus capital R into pi by 2 plus beta plus AO. So if we simplify this equation, then we will get 2 into R. So it will be 2 into pi into R, because 2 will be cancel out, minus 2 beta R plus 2 into pi into capital R. This 2 will be cancel out. Sorry. It will be pi small r. It will be pi into small r, because 2 will be cancel out here. Minus 2 beta r plus, again 2 will be cancel out. So pi, it will be pi into capital R. Pi into capital R plus 2 beta R plus AO into 2. So here LO equals to 5 into capital R plus small r plus 2 into beta into capital R minus small r plus 2 into AO. Now from the triangle AOB, now from the triangle AOB, if we consider this triangle as an opposite direction, then the value of cos beta will be here base by hypotenuse. So base is here AO and hypotenuse is AB. Base is AO, hypotenuse is AB. So cos beta value will be from the triangle, cos beta will be cos beta equals to AO by AB. AO by AB. So from here AO equals to AB into cos beta, and AB is here, AB is the distance between the center of the two pulley. That distance will be here denoted by C. That distance will be denoted by here C. So AB is here C. So if AB is here C, then AO equals to C into cos beta. This is the equation number 1. And this is the equation number 2. So put the value of AO into this equation number 2, then we will get LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2 beta into capital R minus small r plus 2 into C into cos beta. That is the equation number 3. That is the equation number 3. Now we all know that sine square beta, we have already knew that is sine square beta plus cos square beta equals to 1. So from here cos square beta equals to 1 minus sine square beta. So cos beta equals to 1 minus sin square beta whole to the power half. It means root. So from here cos beta equals to root over 1 minus sin square beta. Now if we applying the binomial theory, if we apply the binomial theory, theorem onto the equation number 4 on equation 4, then it will be cos beta equals to 1 minus half sin square beta plus, it will be going up to the nth term. So we have to take here cos beta equals to 1 minus half sin square beta. So if we take this term of 1 minus half sin square beta, then actually cos beta equals to 1 minus half sin square beta. That is the equation number 5. Now from this triangle, from the triangle, from the triangle AOB, sine beta equals to, from this triangle AOB, sine beta, if we see this triangle from the opposite side of my copy, then triangle AOB, sine beta, that is the angle beta, sine beta equals to perpendicular by hypotenuse. So it will be OB by AB. So OB by AB. OB by AB. So OB is here. OB equals to, here OB equals to, OB equals to here BH minus OH. BH minus OH. So what is the value of BH? BH, that is the capital R, that is the radius of the larger pulley. So BH equals to capital R minus OH, that is OH is parallel to here AG. OH is parallel here, parallel with AG. OH here, OH is parallel with AG, and AG is the, OH is parallel with AG, and AG equals to OH, and AG equals to small r, that is the radius of the smaller pulley. So small r, and AB equals to C. So sine beta equals to capital R minus small r by C. So if we put the value of cos beta into the equation number 3, then LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2 into beta into capital R minus small r plus 2 into C. Value of cos beta equals to 1 minus half sine square beta. So it will be LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2 into beta into capital R minus small r plus 2C, that will be 2C remain, minus Q2 will be cancel out here, C into sine square beta. So here C into sine square beta, so LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2 beta into capital R minus small r plus 2C minus C into sine square beta. So now LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2 into beta into capital R minus small r plus 2 into C minus C into sine beta value. Sine beta value is capital R minus small r by C. So if we put this value here into this equation, then it will be capital R minus small r whole square by C square. So CC will be cancelled out, so 1C will be remaining here. So ultimately LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2 into beta into capital R minus small r plus 2C minus capital R minus small r whole square by C. So ultimately we will get LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2 into beta capital R minus small r capital R minus small r plus 2c minus capital R minus small r whole square by C. So sine beta equals to, this is the equation number here 6. Now sine beta equals to capital R minus small r by C. It is, value of sine beta is very much small, so that we can write beta equals to capital R minus small r by C. So value of sine beta is very much small, that's why we can also write, instead of sine beta, we can also write beta equals to capital R minus small r by C. Now put this value of beta into the equation number 6, then we will get LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2 into capital R minus small r by C into capital R minus small r plus 2C minus capital R minus small r whole square by C. So LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2C, and it will be 2 into capital R minus small r whole square by C minus capital R minus small r whole square by C. This term, so if we simplify this equation, then it will become LO equals to pi into small r plus capital R plus 2C plus capital R minus small r whole square by C. So ultimately the length of the belt for the open belt drive will be pi into small r plus capital R plus capital R minus small r whole square by C plus 2C. So that will be the formula which is applicable to calculate the length of the belt for the open belt drive. This is the formula which is used in numerical, which can be used in numerical to solve or to calculate the length of the belt for the open belt drive.